And welcome to Seed Story Cup Day 2. It's AK Wonder and Powder from SK Gaming, and we are going to cast the first game of the day. How is it going, Powder?
It's going good. Yeah, kind of sad that we both lost yesterday, but...
That's why we are here.
It happens, but we're happy to come cast for you guys a good match between Mr. Radu and Just Saiyan.
Yeah, I lost against Saiyan yesterday. So yeah, at least I will be with him, like to cheer for him right now. Just like if he wins the tournament, I always can say yeah.
I lost to the winner.
Yeah. So well, we know all the decks and the bans right now. It's Radu with Druid, Shaman, and Warrior. Yep. I don't know exactly the archetypes, but I can imagine Jog Druid. I can imagine Midrain or Aggro Shaman, but coming from
aggro, I think.
Yeah, coming from Radu, it's gonna be aggro. And Warrior.
They've all been playing OTK Warrior in the G2 camp so far. So okay. I'm expecting that. But you never know. Someone might be thinking that OTK isn't as good and wanting to bring Dragon or Tempo, which is probably one of the stronger decks right now.
And then from Just Saiyan, we have Jog, Kasun Druid.
Yep.
So it's like half Jog, half Kasun.
Yeah, I've seen the deck. I like the idea. I haven't played it myself, but I like the idea of having... It's the second win condition. You change it from the normal Jog Druid. You cut Violet Teacher, you cut the buffs, and then you just play some Kasun cards and just get... Sometimes you can even make big Kasuns with that deck also, so it's pretty interesting.
And then we have Warlock, which is no one knows that Warlock.
Yeah, he hasn't
because
played it yet.
It was always banned. And then the Warrior, which is Dragon Tempo Warrior.
Yep.
The aggro tempo
yep.
Warrior. So they are just starting right now, I believe.
Just getting ready.
So
who do you think do you think anyone's favored just because of the decks?
I think Just Saiyan.
It's very similar, right?
Yeah, but Just Saiyan with the Dragon Tempo Warrior can beat easily Shaman, and also I could say Druid.
Yeah, I think the Dragon Just Saiyan's Dragon Warrior is pretty strong in this matchup.
And
it's
going to
be interesting.
I don't know about the Warlock, so I don't. I expect here Azu, so
yeah.
We are going to see right now the
okay.
Zoo because they just started. Well, I don't know the Zoo.
Yeah, my computer is bugged. I need to go out and spectate again.
Okay, spectate again. Sorry, guys. That's something that happens sometimes. So, yeah, I'm watching actually Radu's hand. We don't know about Just Saiyan Warlock yet. But, yeah, Radu seems like a standard... Shaman, not concede Shaman at least.
There we go.
And just Saiyan has his Shaman banned,
yep.
Which is like the concede Shaman.
Yep.
With Bog Creeper, the one
right.
Frodan is playing. And yeah,
there
it's Zoo. So I really like Just Saiyan lineup here against Radu.
Yeah, I think he's a little bit favored. Just seeing, I was a little bit worried that it might be Reno just because he was playing the concede or the more controller Shaman.
Yeah.
And I mean, this is definitely the matchup he wanted when he picked Zoo against Radu here. It's like the Zoo against Druid is not that good. The Zoo against Warrior is not that good. So he managed
Shaman.
To queue against the deck he really wanted.
What do you think about Radu banning the Conceit Shaman?
I think it's
correct?
pretty good. I think all of his decks are kind of. I think he was worried that Saiyan was gonna ban Warrior.
Uh-huh.
And then
going 3-0 with it,
yeah.
Concede.
But we're into the game, so we see that both hands are really strong. RDU had the perfect opening with the Tunnel Trog into Totem Golem, but we see the answer from Just Saiyan with 4 one drops in his opening hand,
yeah.
Which is D-nuts. You always want as many one drops, just spam your minions against Shaman. It is the way to win.
So you play Totem Golem here, and you trade.
I mean, you have two things you could do. I guess you could Rockbiter, but that just leaves a really good trade for the Flame Imp.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess you play Totem Golem. I don't know if you trade because
yeah,
it just
trade.
Opens up.
The
Dire Wolf is like
yeah,
insane if you trade.
It's just the only card. But
it's
if
true.
You don't trade,
it's true.
He can play Abusive, and then you're in a bad spot.
Yep.
And Abusive is like most likely. Well, no, it's
the same because yeah, you play two.
Yeah, I don't know.
So what do you think he's gonna do here?
Oh, yeah.
I guess you trade with that and play the Argent Squire and just go face. I guess you could play the Voidwalker just to make that you always have the same trade next turn. But this is actually gonna be pretty bad for Saiyan here. RDU has one of the best answers he could with the Rockbiter into the Finley.
Yeah. Right now the Shaman is in a good spot, but in this matchup it's not just the early game. Like sometimes the zoo just keep drawing cards. If you don't get that much damage in your face.
I do feel though that the way the Shaman, like if the Shaman is ever gonna win, they have to be able to contest the board early, and that's what he's doing here. He actually has a pretty good board state going into turn four with no overload. He doesn't really, we can see that his hand is kind of weak, but what can you do? It's like if he has this, if he top decks the 7/7 here, I think he's in a really good spot.
Yeah, I think that the win condition,
an Argent Horse Rider, that's a good card. That's pretty good.
The win condition for the Shaman is to get value out of the Flameton Totem. Oh, you know what? I didn't see, but the Finlay gave to the Shaman the Warlock Hero Power.
Yeah,
so that's
good, huge.
Yep. Because now you will have the same amount of cards as the Sioux.
Yep.
And if you are ahead on board, that you're going to be definitely in a good spot.
There are some things that can change the matchup really, like, really quickly. For example, Forbidden Ritual is like one of the strongest cards you can have. Like, say he just plays Forbidden Ritual here. It would be really good because he would get 4/1/1s, which actually trade really well because you have so many buffs. So I feel like the Warlock's still in a pretty... It's pretty close. I think RDU's found a good board state here. He can play the Thing from Below next turn if he doesn't top deck anything else.
I don't think Councilman here is good. I think I prefer... Tap and Knife Juggler. Here you are like dying to Rockbiter, Flameton Totem, a lot of things.
Yeah, I think you might have to take that risk though.
Yeah, but it's
just, hard.
I mean, even if you don't die immediately, it's not like a good minion to have on board
right now. What do you think is better here? Playing the Lava Burst and the 2-drop?
Yeah, of course.
Or just playing Thing from Below?
No. If you can punish the 1/5 like with a spell.
But the thing is, if you do this, if you play Lava Burst and then play the 2-drop after that, you don't have a minion to play next turn.
Alright,
so he chooses to tap. So now I imagine he's just going to play Lava Burst and then he has a play next turn. So I kind of like it.
Okay.
He doesn't really need to develop another minion. He'll still have the 3-2.
Well, but like as we said, having the board control is just the most important thing. So having a 2-3... It allows to trade with a Knife Juggler, for example.
Ooh, he's going to leave it up if he doesn't get Flame Tongue.
I don't understand.
No, I don't really like this. I mean, I guess he can trade like this, and then it always dies next turn, no matter what, right? But it does give the Councilman a pretty good trade, and most of the time he's just going to get a 3-2 out of it, which, like you said, I don't really agree with this play. I would have liked to seen the Lava Burst, at least. I like the way he tapped and then just left a 3-2. He would have been able to play at least the Flame Juggler. He top decked the Tusker Totemic.
I think, like, RDU wanted to play the Tusker Totemic to decrease the mana cost of the Things from Below.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it's worth it.
I mean, I like the way Justine is thinking here. I was more in the line of just trade your minions. He only has a totem. But he's thinking like one step ahead where if he might know that RDU doesn't run storms. I haven't checked out RDU's list. So that just means that he knows that RDU is going to have to start trading off these minions because the Sioux has better ways. Ooh, that's a big one. That's a big one. If the Flame Juggler hit there, I mean, it doesn't really matter that much, but it still allows Just Saiyan to have an extra 1-1 on board after this Power Overwhelming, which is pretty good.
Now, the Juggler is more important than before. So if you go Knife Juggler and trade, you have a 50-50 to have a good trade next turn. Or you don't play the Knife Juggler because you want to play like two minions and Argus next turn if you want, if you get one mana.
I mean, the thing is, you're very likely to top deck a something for Argus next turn.
Mm-hmm.
Most of your deck is three and below, so he missed.
Oh, feels bad, man.
But it's it. This is when the Warlock Hero power that RDU got off the Finley is becoming really important. He can tap into everything now, and he's just. Like, where Warlock normally, like, gets ahead is they can tap into more cards, and Shaman just runs out of answers. Now he can tap and have as many cards as Sisu, which is really strong.
Doomhammer is insane, right?
Yep.
Because now, like, you will not use it as a burst. Well, if you need it, you will, but you will use it to remove minions, small minions, and to put your minions in, right?
Yeah.
Insane.
Dark Peddler's pretty good.
Well, that's a three... That's a two and a one mana minion, so you can Argus.
Yeah, so you can Argus
nice.
Two. So which one do you take, the Stone Tusk or the Murloc Raider?
I think the boar.
Is there any value? You could take the Blood Imp try to buff your...
It's too late, man. Like now, you don't have time to play for the boar control.
So you have a 2-2 charge, a 3-2, and you decide to go for the 3-2 just for the extra damage, I guess. The 2-2 would be pretty bad because the Flame Juggler just trades into it efficiently.
Yeah. I agree. That's true. Maybe it was just correct to take the Murloc.
Yeah, I think so.
But I
think he definitely made the right choice.
Twitch chat will say missed 2 damage.
Missed 2 damage. I mean,
actually one, because you
depends,
are going to take three.
Depending on what deck you're playing, the Shaman is actually getting a little bit low here.
Yeah.
Like, you kind of expect him to take a little bit more damage, so the 2 extra damage here is actually, like, he would have been on 10
mm-hmm.
or 11, which is getting kind of okay. Like, there are some really good cards for the Warlock here, and he really needs to top deck. Like, Forbidden Ritual, best card. Doomguard. Pretty good top deck.
So we can say that the Sue is not drawing that well, and the hero power, like the Shaman new hero power, is just too strong.
Yeah.
So the game is just. Yeah. Now.
So how close is he to lethal?
The Shaman.
This might be lethal.
The Shaman could be on
4, 8,
5.
10, 13. Yeah, it's lethal.
2, 4, 5, 9 plus 9, 18.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think it's 17.
Oh, what?
You get 4 and you get 8. 6 in the middle is 10. You get 3. 13, 15, 17. Yeah, 17.
Okay. Akka Wonder Maths.
Akka Wonder Maths. I mean, if you're just saying here, you obviously lost the favorite matchup.
You're in a bad spot right
now. Like that's how last year's standing often works. You have certain decks to counter other decks, and if you lose with your counter deck, you're in a really bad position.
Yeah, because now, what do you play against? Well, you have your warrior,
which is
good against his shaman. So he's gonna insta kill with warrior, but you missed your chance to beat.
I mean, actually, if you look at the decks, I think Jossain's decks are just so strong against what RDU is playing. That he might actually be... He's still in an okay spot. If he can play the warrior here and beat the shaman, like RDU doesn't really have a good counter to the warrior.
He's still in a good spot because the lineup is just too good against RDU.
Yeah.
But...
Like, that's the thing. Like, just saying, like, with his shaman being banned, his shaman was the controller shaman, which is very unorthodox. And it's not, like, what you kind of expect. But the other decks are, like... The three probably strongest decks in the meta right now, and they can always just 3-0 someone. And when you have the Tempo Dragon Warrior, which is just curve insane, like against Shaman, which is what it was built to beat, then RDU is most likely gonna go. He has Yogg-Druid and OTK Warrior left. The OTK Warrior should maybe be favored, but I've been playing OTK Warrior all morning, and against Dragon Warrior, sometimes they just face roll you. They just to go face, and you can't do anything.
Yeah.
But he has to win this matchup first.
He took his time, but finally
He decided with.
Yeah, he chooses the warrior, which is.
He has the Alexstrasza's champion, which is by far the best card, but he does not have a dragon yet, so I
think
I expect him to.
Both cards.
Yeah, I mean, Frothing is a good card, but I expect him to mulligan the Frothing just to like have as much chance to just draw a dragon as possible.
Okay. And from Radu's perspective, we have the 4-mana 7/7, Things from Below, Flame Tontorem, and Rogue Biter.
Yeah.
So I believe Rogue Biter is going to be a keep. And he's gonna mulligan away three cards.
You're going second with no like. I think if you had like one other good card, you keep Rockbiter 100%.
Mm-hmm.
Not having a single one drop or two drop, it is kind of worse to keep Rockbiter.
But Rockbiter is just too good against.
Yeah,
three
Rockbiter is good, but it's better to get Totem Golem into a one drop.
Okay.
Yeah, so he threw away everything. I like it. I would have done the same.
And Jessian kept the 3-mana drop.
I'm not.
It's fine. It's fine. But I think it's too much value to have a dragon in the starting hand.
I mean, if you think about it, if the shaman has Totem Golem, I think every time if they have Totem Golem, they're gonna go Totem Golem on one, and then the Alexstrasza's champion isn't actually that good.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes a little bit of sense to keep the Frothing as a kind of, you know, you have a 2-drop and a 3-drop. If I draw a dragon, which is kind of likely anyways, I still have something to play on 3. It's still like one of the best cards. Like, why would I throw it away?
I don't know. I think I prefer to play, like...
Dragon!
That's good. But I think I prefer anyway to play... in turn 3, Fireware Axe or turn 2.
It depends.
I don't think I like Frothing Berserker against Shaman that much.
What do you do here? It's actually kind of hard because
the 3-3
doesn't do much.
Nah, you play the 3-3 and Inner Rage.
You think so?
Yeah, because you have to play. Oh. That's okay.
It's interesting. I think it's just like.
Yeah, I like it.
I think he's hoping like any one drop here, he can charge into with the Alexstrasza's champion.
I like it. Yeah, I agree.
It is a little bit weak when if he plays a 4/4 on 7, 7/7 on 4.
Yeah, of course it's gonna be punished, but I think anyway is correct. If he has everything, like in this case, if he has the 4-mana 7/7, it's gonna be bad for him, but. I think it's correct anyway overall. Because
I mean,
now you
it
can
might
charge.
Actually, it might actually be correct anyways because, like, most 3-drops here, like, say, what do you normally do on 3? You do
Tuskar
or Ferals. If you do Ferals, like, you go Alexstrasza's champion,
you can trade
with your thing. You're in a really good spot.
Yeah.
He can only have 2 mana.
Yeah.
Perfect. If he goes Tuskar, you can trade your Alexstrasza's into like the totem, trade with the Tuskar with your thing,
mm-hmm.
and then your Frothing is actually going to be really big when the 7/7 comes out. So I like the idea as well.
Yeah,
I like it.
Interesting. Now it's going to be a 8/1 and a 3/3 on board. No, a 5/1.
A 5/1.
And a 3/3 on board. So.
So now, like, do you actually want to play the 7/7 when it has a like
nope.
It's being traded on board?
Nope.
So yeah. I mean, you have the perfect play, so yes. Why would you play the 7/7? Like, this is just
countering
so good.
Counter into counter. And it's important here to play Lightning Bolt because you have a 4-drop next turn.
Yep. Are you making the right moves so far?
Uh-huh. And now what?
Ooh, interesting. Do you kill it or do you play a taunt?
I think
I would play the taunt. You don't have an execute. You already used one, so maybe this is better. But I think it's hard. I think it's a decision worth.
I think I would have played the Guardian on curve.
Yeah. Oh, he's playing Onyxia. That's interesting.
Well, now you play the Crusher and you go face.
Yeah.
And if he trades, I don't know what you're gonna do.
Like, this actually worked out so well for RDU that he could go. He can play second 7/7 here.
No. You prefer to. To play like Tuskar and
he could. In this scenario, Tuskar clearing the 3/3 is pretty good because he
can't. You saw the goal, you saw one in a rage.
Yeah.
How is he gonna remove like this? Yeah. The 7-1 is impossible.
Yeah, the 7-1's gonna be really
with
strong.
With Blood to Ichor, maybe. Yeah. Onyxia. So I think Jaskayan is playing Onyxia instead of Death Queen, which makes sense as well, right?
Yep.
Interesting.
But he's also playing one Inner Rage, so I don't know what he cut. I guess Slam? he cut Malrock for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I guess maybe a Slam, yeah.
Or the 4-3 with Church? I don't think so.
No, it's just too good in Temple Dragons.
I don't know. Maybe so, Blood to Ichor, so Slams? Something like
maybe.
That?
Maybe. But he does play the 7-7.
Yeah. Smark.
I mean, then you always go face, right? Ooh, that's a good top
deck. That's really good.
He gets a little bit punished here.
Look at the curve now. 8 and 9.
Yeah, it's really...
Both are having just the insane curves,
yeah.
and the best answer to the opponent's question,
yeah.
All the time.
I do think it is a little bit of a mistake there to play the 7-7, though.
I think so.
I would have liked to see the Toskar into maybe Rockbiter or Lightning Bolt. Probably the Lightning Bolt, just because you don't really care about the having one less mana next turn. But this is also a really important top deck here for RDU. Like, he was running out of stuff to do damage. He's been fighting for the board this entire time. And now he top decks the card that's, like, one of the best card in Shaman. It's why you can play Face Shaman. It's Doomhammer.
Do you play Rockbiter? I
think so. I mean, at this point, you're just... Okay, I have board control. I still have 16 damage from
the weapon. Now you have to play Ragnaros,
yeah,
and Prey.
It feels a little bit bad just because 50% of the time the outcome is going to be really bad, but 25% of the time you... Yeah.
Rip in Pepperoncinos.
I think that might be the game. So he's going to do 10, 14 this turn.
So you go Doomhammer Hero Power here?
No, you go Doomhammer Argent Squire.
No.
Why would you go Hero Power?
I don't know. I want to have like tokens to Hero Power every turn. I have a limited amount of cards. I mean,
the Argent Squire, like at this point...
Town is okay. Healing
is
okay.
At this point, I think he's... I mean, the only thing he's thinking about most likely is... Do I Lava Burst and kill the Rag? Which I would be so surprised if he does this, because it makes no sense.
No.
Like, I mean, I don't think you ever Hero Power, because the Argent Squire is just like, imagine if the Rag hits the Argent Squire, it's like even better. It's the same. Like, it's basically if Jaskayan doesn't have an answer this turn,
mm-hmm.
he's dead. Like, no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
So he needs this Rag to hit the 7-5, I believe.
Oh.
Or top deck executes.
La 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 la. Look at Jaskayan's face. Like,
yeah, I think he's pretty happy about that one.
Yeah, that's insane.
The question is, do you War Axe
or Armor Up?
I think you Armor Up, because if you War Axe, your Rag becomes even worse.
Yeah, that's
it's
true.
It's like 50-50 to hit the Divine Shield.
Yeah,
so he wants to hit the 3-2, and he does.
Yeah.
That turn. But one
Ooh.
Damage off. That's a top deck.
This game is insane, man.
Spell?
Armor up.
No,
armor
no spell
up
power.
Was like really important, right?
Yeah, but still.
And
I
Ragnaros
think...
33% was
yeah,
important.
But it won't matter in the end, I think. He needs to top deck the taunt. That's the only minion that saves.
Or something
he's
that
on,
goes face.
He's on 8. No, he's dead no matter what. I think the taunt was the only card, the only out there.
What taunt?
The 3-6 taunt.
Okay.
He had the second one.
Yeah, rip. Wow.
Unfortunate. I mean, I think...
So he's losing 2 times against
I think
a Shaman.
After that rag, I think Jaskayan was really favored there. Like, RDU needed exactly
Rockbiter,
I think.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe the second Lava Burst would have done it. Which he top deck now as well. It's pretty good.
Oh my god. This is unfair for Jaskayan. Like, having the best... Having just a lineup that counters RDU, and then, like, playing decent?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think he's made any mistakes so far.
I feel like...
I mean, that it happens. That's why you play shaman. It is just why you play shaman.
No, but it's not about shaman. Like, it was only one out for RDU because he played already one
fighter.
Yeah,
I mean, it's just...
It's just unfair sometimes. Hearthstone. Yeah, but I feel bad for Cyan.
But it's not over yet, Akka. He can still do it. He has Druid.
Yeah, that's
And
true.
I like this matchup. I like it.
Do you?
I think it's okay.
I think it's the worst.
I think
right now, like
face
the
shaman against. I mean, he's playing the more this like more taunts, C'Thun also. I like this matchup. I like it.
Okay, now the RDU cards are the 4-mana 7/7, the Argent Horse Rider, and the Flametone Totem. So
yeah,
you
so you full mulligan.
Okay,
definitely.
And for Cyan is Disciple of C'Thun. I always keep this card. It's just one of my favorite cards.
Disciple of C'Thun.
Yeah, Raven Eyeball is just mathematically. Important to keep.
I think.
And then you mulligan away C'Thun Chosen and Yogg-Saron.
Against Shaman, I think Disciple of C'Thun is really bad.
No, it's really good.
You only kill Tusker.
You don't need to kill
you
Tusker.
You only
to be
kill
good.
Tusker.
You can play it against the Totem Golem. You can play it against any Totem.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think I would throw it away, but I don't think it's that good.
I think it's just insane. It's worse than against Zoo, but it's just an early card that kills a card and it stays
on
board. Yeah,
I mean, my reasoning would be that...
Ooh, no.
He didn't keep Raven Idol.
Okay, he wants Living Roots, I understand, but...
Oh, RDU's hand is so bad.
Punished.
Wow, punished.
Nah, just kidding. Okay. The game, the early game for Yasayan is just insane. Yeah. That's why
he
you play C'Thun.
Basically C'Thun. The nuts without innervate.
Okay, here doesn't matter about Jog. It's just C'Thun things.
Yeah.
That's why you play C'Thun. Because you play on curve and you win against everything.
Yeah.
Especially against aggro, of course.
Well, I mean, this game is looking kind of unfortunate. I think... RDU has to hope that he can go totem, thing from below, and then into his Doomhammer and still have a chance.
No way.
I mean that's his only way to play this game. I don't think you can ever play Ferals here. It's just too weak with your hand.
So what do you do?
You play totem, and then you go thing from below into Doomhammer.
What about the 3-mana spell.
The Ferals?
No, the Lava Burst.
Oh,
kill
Lava
the 3-4,
Burst on the 3-4?
And then pray for, like, a bad curve.
Yeah, maybe. But then you hero power and you don't do anything.
Yeah, but you don't expect the Druid to play a minion on turn 3.
I guess.
But he's gonna play...
I guess it might be the right play.
Yeah, he's gonna play Disciple of C'Thun anyway.
Yeah,
that's
he
correct.
Has two.
Mm-hmm. I like it. I think the Lava Burst was the correct play.
I mean, you never know. He might top deck something as like. There's a lot of 2-drops, 1-drops. He can top deck here as well. He did not, unfortunately, for RDU. He can go totem into totem, thing from below next turn. But I think it's a little bit too late for him. The curve of just saying has just been too strong.
Yeah. C'Thun. I love C'Thun, man. I know what.
Ooh.
I know what. Oh, maybe you can like the Trog plus.
I think I like Doomhammer.
And you take 8 damage?
Yep.
And next turn with 4 mana?
You play the thing from below.
No,
you play Trog Ferals.
Okay.
I think you have a chance.
No, you don't, but it's the best play.
I think you have a chance, actually. I mean, if just saying, like, if you do this, I mean, I guess this is the same, because you can do, you would have done this next turn anyways. I think it depends a lot on, that's a good topic.
Nerdish is, no.
No, you do this for sure. 100%, 100%, 100%, every time.
Yeah, that's fine.
Like
turn.
Against Face Shaman with 4 mana, what can he do? He doesn't play Hex.
Okay, so you go YOLO here and next turn Nourish if you need it. Yeah, I like it.
Yeah, but that sealed the game. I think that Innervate was probably the best pickup he could have found, if not a 5 drop. And that just sealed the game 100%.
Okay.
So here he has good trades, another Innervate so he can go Nourish for cards, and then Innervate out the Disciple.
Yeah.
So strong.
Yesayan, Druid, best Druid.
Best Druid. I mean, he 3-0'd a lot of people with Druid yesterday. That's all I know.
What?
Not just me. Saying.
Not me.
He 3-0'd Purple with Druid in the Deciders match.
Mm-hmm.
And he was 2-0 off against Ignite with Druid. That's
okay.
All I know.
Okay.
So he won a lot against Druid.
Turn 7. Turn 8.
Is there any way he can come back into this game? What's the best play to come back?
Another level boost.
You can lightning bolt the 4-2. You get rid of it.
No. You
oh no! You lightning bolt the 5-5.
Yeah.
5, kill those two. You take 9, and then you play thing from below. And he
no,
can't.
No.
You don't
no.
think why? I think that's the play.
Yeah, I think you play 2 lightning bolts. You kill all the ward, then you develop Totem and Iron Squire. And then next turn you're gonna play everything plus thing from below. I was thinking about that play.
The light protects me. I don't know. I like the other play, I think.
Yeah.
There's not that many ways where the Druid, he's used both of his Disciple of C'Thun's. I think both plays are pretty similar. But yeah.
Yeah, but now you have a 5-5 on board instead of this, unless. And you take.
You would have taken
three
extra damage.
Oh, 2, 4, 5. That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. You can play.
You can play everything.
Power, Totem, Golem, Flameton, Totem. Totem.
So you trade and then you put the thing from below next to the Totem Golem, and it's actually not looking that bad anymore. Depending on what, like, Swipe would just wreck. He does have Druid of the Claw charge into the Twilight Elder, which is also pretty strong.
Dark Urko. I think you can, like, Druid of the Claw with charge.
Yeah, you charge.
Hero power, and then the
5-7
into the 0-3. And next turn, you're gonna play Dark Urko plus Elder.
Yeah, I like it. I like this a lot better. My play was kind of stupid compared to this, to be honest.
The only way to lose is because of the Flameton Totem?
Yep.
No, you're fine.
Yeah, you always kill the Flametongue there. 100%.
You can't hit with the weapon more than one time.
So.
Good curve.
Yeah. I mean, RDU did his best to come back in this game, and he was actually pretty close to doing it.
Mm-hmm.
But those two innervates just sealed the game, 100%.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like especially the first innervate. If he didn't top deck innervate there, I think this game would have been a lot closer. I think he just top deck C'Thun and that would have sealed the game 100%, even without the innervates and when RDU had the board. Because you see, the C'Thun is 20-20.
Mm-hmm. 20-20, good C'Thun.
But it's nice. We
I
don't.
Like it.
He takes a game. I like it. I like it. Comeback train. Comeback train.
For me,
I believe.
Well, you said it was like a good match, a decent matchup for the.
Yeah, I think it's fine.
Okay, now I believe you, but he's winning the worst matchup.
Yeah, I mean, so it's for sure the worst matchup.
And now look at this. And now the mirror is just too bad for the Druid, for the C'Thun Druid.
It depends. The way like the normal Yogg Druid, which RDU is playing, the way they win. The reason why they are probably more favored is because of Violet Teacher.
Power of the Wild.
That combo is just so insane where you can wait a while because C'Thun Druid is slower.
Uh-huh.
And you can wait for a pretty long time. So you can set up a board where you have so many like tokens, buff them, and then the C'Thun Druid just doesn't have an answer. That's why sometimes just like board state of Sue just gets out of hand because the minions are too strong. You can't swipe it because they're 2/2s or 3/3s. But if RDU doesn't find this combo, doesn't find the Violet Teacher, which doesn't always happen, you can't always make a bunch of tokens.
About the Radu's hand, he had a Violet Teacher on the
starting. I think
hand.
I would have kept it.
And he mulliganed it away.
Yeah, I would have thrown away Fandral. I don't know why he kept Fandral, actually.
And he kept Fandral. Yeah, that's real.
I don't really like that. I think it kind of shows a little bit. I mean, I don't know this matchup 100%, and RGU might know this matchup better than me, but in my opinion, I think that's the way you win, by playing the Violet Teacher, getting that combo, because the C'Thun Druid is stronger than you. It has stronger minions where, mm-hmm. I mean, it's playing C'Thun. C'Thun is super strong.
Yeah. Well, actually, we didn't see the Beklar, Emperor Beklar, which is the most...
The 410?
No, the legendary C'Thun
card.
No,
I'm sure he's playing it. I'm sure he's playing it.
Okay. Because this card is just insane in the mirror. 2-4-6 for 7 mana?
Yeah.
The dream.
Yeah, I mean, it's insane. But we also see that Just Saiyan had Wild Growth, and RGU's hand is really slow. He has coin into 4/4. Ooh, that's a top deck. He can go innervate, nourish for mana into the 3 if he wants.
I don't think
you want to do it, but
do you think in C'Thun Jog Druid having more mana is better?
In this case, I think so.
You don't need a lot of...
The thing is, like, I would do it if I didn't, like, we just played Wild Growth, going first against another druid who did not have Wild Growth. So we're already 2 mana ahead.
Uh-huh.
So that's the thing. We're already 2 mana ahead. Do we want to be 4 mana ahead? Maybe, with our hand?
I think you want to nourish, because you want more cards to buff C'Thun.
If that swipe was a 6 drop,
yeah, then definitely.
I would do it 100%.
Yeah, yeah.
But now it's
Dark
a swipe.
Akua, for example.
Yeah, now it's a swipe. It's kind of awkward.
Yeah, I agree.
I think there's the chance of you top decking something. Oh, he top decked Innervate. That's good. Oh,
that's sick.
That's
so good.
That's so sick. Oh.
Yeah.
That's probably the best top deck he had.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Harrison Jones, interesting.
Yeah, so now you have like to charge and hero power. That's
just
my fault.
Just leave it.
Sorry. Yeah, so hero power, yeah. and charge and...
You have to use your innervate for just a hero power.
Mm-hmm.
It feels kind of bad, mm-hmm. but in a way, it's also okay that you're leaving a 4-1 up, because mm-hmm. there's not a lot of the time where... Okay, we know RDU's hand is pretty bad at this point.
Uh-huh.
If you're just saying, like... He's most likely want to play a 4-drop, maybe like a Mire Keeper or something. And you can't really play a 4-drop into a 4-1 because uh-huh. it doesn't make sense. Now we top deck Raven Idol, which makes RDU's choice a lot easier, I think.
So do you play Mire Keeper here?
I don't think so.
Why not?
I think if he didn't top deck the Raven Idol, say he top decked like a 5-drop or something, I think you play the Mire Keeper instead of Hero Power. Like, you're just giving up a free trade.
Yeah,
I don't like it.
But you gain a mana crystal forever, and you don't lose the whole turn. Spell or minion?
Minion.
Spell.
It depends on what you want to do with your nourish. If you're thinking that you want to nourish 100% this turn, I like nourishing first, like he did.
Uh huh.
And now you take a spell, every time.
Backlore, love it. Yeah, spell, something like Swipe is good.
Wrath, Healing Test, Raven.
Wrath or Raven Idol?
So, is Wrath better than Raven Idol? He thinks so.
I mean...
I think it's close.
You have already a Swipe, so Wrath is a decent card, of course. But in this match, if he plays like Violet Teacher, Innervate, Power of the Wild...
2 seconds. We see Claw, Savage Roar, and Starfire off RDU's Raven.
Yeah. He took Starfire.
He took Starfire.
Over...
I mean, I agree with it, I think. Ooh, that's also interesting. So now we see the Yogg from Just Saiyan. I mean, he's never going to have, like,
the
insane Yogg.
Look at Starfire plus Living Roots.
It doesn't kill it, though. It's 9.
Oh, shit.
It's close.
Almost.
Almost.
Yeah, so you.
So you top deck the Ancient. It's pretty good. But so what do we have? We have Swipe Wrath to clear the board here, which is pretty strong.
Swipe what?
Swipe Wrath.
Mm-hmm.
Hero power. Yeah.
I like it.
You can also use the Living Roots if you want to idle, or just get something off the Raven Idol. Moonfire works. I guess you take. Okay. I wish you could hide this. So you swipe. hit Moonfire kills it without using the Living Roots. Is it worth it to take the Moonfire just because of that?
I think we can hide from you. You can.
Oh, yeah. I'm stupid.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. So he took the Wrath. I'm a little bit surprised. He might just like the idea here might be for him. He's only gonna swipe here. And not actually clear because it is a little bit mana initially.
I don't think you want to swipe because you know he's playing Ballet Teacher. Oh, he's gonna.
He's defense. Clearing.
Why not Wrath, Trade, Living Roots? It's just too inefficient.
I mean, that's why I would have probably taken the.
But now Radu knows that he used the swipe, so he's gonna play Ballet Teacher and a bunch of spells.
But he doesn't have a bunch of spells, though.
Okay, so Starfire, next turn, he's going to play... Yeah, but you have Jok. It's fine. You have both Jok and C'Thun.
Yeah, your C'Thun isn't that big, though. Your C'Thun is only 7-7, I believe.
Yeah, you need a Dark Arakoa or...
Yeah, it's 7-7.
Yeah, Dark Arakoa or something like that.
Starfire into another Living Roots. I guess you play one, right?
One, yeah. But not two.
Oh, he plays two.
You never play two, I guess.
You play two.
Oh, wow.
I think he would want to save it. He did just see a swipe. That's a pretty good top deck here. You Wrath for one to draw a card. It's also good for Yogg. I think he's gonna Yogg next turn like 100%.
Oh, now what?
Yeah, I think it's okay.
I don't know if Radu is playing that spell for mana, give your minions Death Rattle, summon a Choo Choo. Do you know? Soul of the Forest.
No, I don't think so.
You sure?
I think it's only Jackie Chan playing that deck.
No, Life Coach as well.
Oh, Life Coach as well?
Yeah.
Interesting.
That's why I wonder if Radu is playing Life Coach list.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't know.
I guess the reason why he played two Living Roots last turn was because he wanted to play Scenarios for mm-hmm. +2/+2,
mm-hmm.
Which did make some sense.
Yeah, but you play one Living Roots and then on turn 10... it's on turn 9.
Yeah.
No, but in turn 9 you want to play Onyxia, and then in turn 10 you want to play like Living Roots plus
It's
Scenarios.
Kind of greedy to play Onyxia and play Scenarios.
It is, but it's a good combo as well.
Yeah, but it seems really greedy to me. Okay. Is there any way... We can't see how many spells he's played, right? It's impossible.
But we know that he played... Wild Growth, Swipe, Graph, Raven Idol, Graph, Living Roots.
I was just about to say, you always play C'Thun here.
Yeah.
It's like 100%.
And
you
a good
clear
trade.
An Onyxia, yeah.
That's really good, man. You need a Mulch to steal C'Thun or you are in a bad spot right now.
I mean, you can always just play Sylvanas. You're on 30 HP. Do you expect, what's the worst thing that can happen to you?
Veklor,
probably. Then you can... you have Wrath now.
Veklor and Elder?
So you can...
Is that even worse?
Veklor Elder is probably the worst thing that could happen.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe Veklor, Living Roots. In the case where his hand...
You don't have swipe.
Yeah, his hand is this. Like, now he's just hoping for the Sylvanas. So just saying here is like, okay, I'm never trading. I'm mm-hmm. always going face.
Mm-hmm.
I have Veklor, but... There is the Wrath.
Yeah, Veklor, Elder, your C'Thun is 10-10, you hit face, and at the end of the turn it's going to be 11-11.
So this...
Mind Control tech is not in the meta.
This Wrath is going to be super big.
Why?
Because he has to take this... Like, the C'Thun is just too strong, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's attacking in. Like, there's no way he's just going to play a Taunt here.
So first you
like
play
he's,
Wrath
he's gonna,
for
he's
one.
He's gonna play a Taunt, but he's gonna Wrath as well.
Wrath your Sylvana for one and then we think?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, this is always gonna happen. It has to happen.
The only
That's not a good card.
No. The only out it was Mulch.
So what do we do? Like, the problem here also is we wanna kill one, so now we're on the train of we have to win this 25% here.
Well, you can get the Taunt.
The 33%.
So it's 66.
Oh my god.
No.
Oh my god.
Okay. In joke,
that's
we believe.
That's so dirty.
I think there are like 12 spells played already. So now it's time for Yogg.
That's so dirty.
Hero power, innervate Yogg.
Yeah.
And that means combo. So every card like Eviscerate or Headcrack is going to be with combo.
Yeah, I'm just feeling so bad for Saiyan. Like, that's just so dirty.
Yeah.
Resurrect.
Before.
That's okay. Frost Shock on the C'Thun.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, perfect.
Never mind.
That doesn't do anything. Lightning Bolt, face.
Choo-choo. Okay.
That's okay.
Punish.
That's a good card.
Oh, no, Shatter! No good prep! You need to get a prep! 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 Oh!
That thing is so big.
No, don't give.
Give it to the C'Thun! Yes! Oh! Yes! Nourish is good.
No! He needed the mana to play Shatter. Not
yeah,
to draw
it's okay.
Card.
But he has Iceland
Shatter.
Into Shatter.
Okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
This is fine.
That's
this is actually
really good
pretty
Yogg.
This is a good Yogg.
Some he's justice. Laughing.
Some
he's
justice.
Laughing. He's just like, ha-ha!
I mean, that's justice. RDU won the 33% chance where Just Saiyan just would have won the game instantly. So uh-huh. I'm feeling a little bit of justice here after the
it's
first two games.
It's 18-18 with Wind Fury, but frozen.
Yeah, but frozen. Imagine if that thing wasn't frozen. That would be so sick.
It's so funny.
I mean, I love the way that it just... Everything buffed the C'Thun. Everything went on the C'Thun.
Yeah.
It's just like... Yeah, you stole my C'Thun, but I'm just going to play Yogg and everything's just going to go on it. Everything. I love it. Can RDU survive here is the question.
Full hand.
Like, can he survive?
I mean, no. Because you have like 4 damage
I mean,
with this card.
Hand,
like,
yeah.
This card deals 4 damage, right?
Yeah,
Dragon's
yeah.
Brief.
I don't think there's a chance.
You have Disciple of C'Thun.
So you have 2 taunts. You can't do anything more than those 2 taunts. You can trade Hero Power. So 7-10.
Because you have Iceland's Shatter.
Yeah, it's way lethal.
Combo Wombo.
So we have game
the
5, guys.
Sweeps. The reverse sweeps. I like this game, man. Iceland's Shatter. Look at Radu's face now. What is this? So funny. This game was awesome, man. I want to see more Druid Mirrors.
That was a good game.
Yes, it's AK Wonder, chat. What's up? Hi, it's me. And it's like, this is why you play Yogg. But also C'Thun, guys. C'Thun Yogg Druid. What? I mean, I should come with that with those ideas sometimes.
Yeah.
Not only
you didn't believe. I told you it was good.
If you like Yogg,
you didn't believe this morning.
And you
are
like,
you a believer now?
Yeah. Now
you're
I like
a believer.
It.
Okay.
Yeah, I like
so
it.
Last matchup is, RDU is playing Dragon Warrior.
Yeah.
I didn't expect that. I thought everyone else is playing OTK Warrior from
yeah,
G2.
Yeah, but Radu is just too aggressive to not play dragons.
So how do we win this as the Druid?
I mean, we don't see
we
the RDU's mulligan, but he has Execute, Brought to Ichor, and Twilight Guardian. I think you want to keep Twilight Guardian, even if you don't have any good
drop.
Yeah,
I always keep Twilight Guardian.
I mean, without the coin, it's just hard to keep, actually.
Yeah, but you need a dragon, so it's a dragon.
Yeah.
It's like one of the lower dragons that you want.
So that means the start of RDU is not going to be good anymore. And we know that Just Saiyan has... awesome early cards with the C'Thun things.
Yeah.
Plus Innervate, plus Living Roots. He kept Druid of the Claw.
I
I'm
like
not
it.
Sure about it.
I think it's okay.
I don't like it. I prefer to buff my C'Thun before. So I can say that Just Saiyan is in a good spot right
now.
And now he can Innervate Twilight Elder. And against the
it's
2 drops, it's just insane.
No, I think you do this.
Why?
Because it's fine. You have you're gonna coin Disciple of C'Thun against anything.
Mm-hmm.
Next turn, I mean, in this case, it just means that okay, there's 2 drops. It's bad against like the only thing is like it's good against everything. I think.
No, I don't like.
I think it's good against everything. I like it.
I think I don't like it.
I like it.
Your Cthulhu needs to be buffed. A 3-4 is like the same as a Tunnel Truck. You want to have it on turn one. I mean, it was just too good. Why not, man?
I mean, you save the Innervate for something better now.
I know what?
Now you Innervate the Druid of the Core.
Oh.
Always. Always.
With charge.
No.
What about Fireware Axe?
Then you have a 3-3. It's fine. Yeah, I think it's definitely fine.
I think I would have played this hand really different.
I think I would have done the same.
You sure? 10-1 Living Threat's third?
Yeah.
Against Dragon Warrior?
Yeah. I mean,
against
okay.
A warrior?
My reasoning is, okay, there's 3 2 drops in the deck. Fairy Dragon, the 3-3 charge, and War Axe.
Yeah.
It's against War Axe, it's definitely fine. Against okay. against the 3-3 charge, it's mm-hmm. fine. The 3-4 is the same.
Mm-hmm.
But against Fairy Dragon, it's way better. What did RDU... In this case, what did RDU have in his hand? Fairy Dragon.
Yeah,
couldn't play
but
it.
You had Disciple of Cthulhu against...
Yeah, but you already kept Druid of the Claw for the reason where you want to innervate out Druid of the Claw.
Okay. It's fine.
So he executes here. A little bit interesting choice, I think.
You had to do it, I believe. Raven Idol, Spell.
Yeah.
You're looking for Wild Growth or Innervate. And now you take Nourish.
Yeah, all the other ones suck.
Yeah.
So
you can play one Nourish for ramping and one Nourish for drawing.
I mean, in some world, maybe you could take Astral Communion,
no,
but...
No.
I don't think so.
Not with Nourish on hand.
But now you're in a really awkward spot here.
Jaskayan got punished.
Yeah, but there's no... I don't think there's any way where you wouldn't get punished there.
Okay.
So that's a good... Oh, he's going to go Azure Drake. I maybe would have liked to see a 1-drop into the 4-drop, but it's about the same. It's pretty good. You can clear. Yeah. But you go Nourish, and then you clear next turn with double Disciple. You mm-hmm. could also do for mana this turn.
Yeah, you have to go for mana here. At least with one of the... I mean, right now it's just mana. Mana and Wrath for 3? No. Mana and Hero Power? Nah, I don't like
I
it.
I mean, you
nah,
want Wrath. To do Disciple on this.
He's going for cards because he's going to play turn 6 to...
Yeah, he knows exactly what he's going to do turn 6.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think it's fine going for cards.
Mm-hmm.
I maybe would have liked to see mana there and then have the chance of drawing later with the Nourish.
Mm-hmm.
But you're always going to have the same chance to do Nourish for mana later, if you want.
But with less mana.
Yeah. Interesting
sure.
choice here. Now I actually think you do Disciple into Twilight Guardian. Into Twilight Elder, I mean. You Disciple on the 3-2.
Mm-hmm.
You only take one extra damage off, mm-hmm. and you play a better minion.
Okay, I like it. It's the only way to kill the 3-2 as a druid. Just to play Disciple of Cthulhu.
Is there any other play you can do? All the other plays seem really mana inefficient. So I really like this play.
Yeah, it's fine. Now your Cthulhu is 10-10, which is like huge. If you have Beklor.
Yep.
I don't think he's running any the 4-10. The 4-mana
4-10. No, I don't think so either.
So... And next turn, he's going to play like Druid of the Claw plus Wrath, something like that.
Yeah,
I'm not sure.
Probably. I mean, the thing is, in this deck, you're running double Arakoa, double 7, double Ancient of War.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have so many taunts. You haven't found them yet, but you're how many cards do you have left? 17 cards left. So you're getting pretty likely to draw one of them eventually. So you have 4 big taunts in your deck left.
Yeah, and he already played one execute.
Yeah, which is very good for
but
you.
But I'm missing some innervates for the druid. I know he already played one.
Yeah, he played one innervate.
He actually needs a second one to like to be ahead because without innervate you can like outvalue the warrior right now on board and well with Yogg.
I mean, I think now he just has to be on the Yogg plan. This board is just too good.
How do you survive here?
You go Nourish for mana.
No way.
Yeah, Nourish for mana.
Mm-hmm.
It gives you... you're one off.
No. Why?
You want Nourish for mana. You want 5 because you really need to kill.
If you go Nourish for mana, you will get 10 mana next turn.
Yeah, then you Yogg. That's so, the thing. That's why you want to Nourish for mana.
For mana, you have 4 mana. You play K'Thun's Chosen or you play
The problem Wrath? Is you're leaving the Frothing up, which is what I don't like. I don't know how many spells you played either. How many do you think?
One Living Roots, one Raven Idol, one Innervate, one Wrath? No. He didn't play a Wrath.
Yeah, he's gonna do this. I like it. You're taking 4 damage off instead of playing Cthulhu's
Chosen. I
think
you play Wild Wrath here, actually.
Just for an extra spell?
Yes, because it's just...
I mean, the thing is, you could, in some... Like, you still have 1 Innervate.
Uh-huh.
So you're 1 in 16 to top deck the Innervate, which gives you 3 extra spells if you wait with the Wild Growth.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if it's worth, but it's just... I think you still save. So how many spells did we get up to?
7, 6.
You just play Rag here, right? What now? Or no, you okay, this and play 9/9. Okay, this is much better.
Because
you wanna save the Rag after. It's like really obvious he's gonna play Yogg.
Uh-huh. Anyway, it has to be a really good Yogg. Like something like Frost Nova.
That's a good card for next turn. I mean, I think you need a board clear. You need a board clear.
It's only 6 spells or so.
Just reset the board.
Oh,
just anything that resets the board. That's a good one.
Not really, right?
I mean, that's fine. As long as you get the board clear. I mean, all you need is the board clear here, and then
or just a Frost Nova. Yeah.
Twisting Nether. That's a good one.
Not really.
Yeah, if you get like, and now you just need.
Yeah, Hydro like there.
Execute on the... That sucks.
Shadow Flame. Oh, rip.
Rip.
So Radu wins. Yes, Cyan tried.
That was...
Worst Yogg EU.
I mean, he didn't have that many spells.
Well, it was like 7 or more.
Yeah. I mean, you're kind of likely to get a board clear, but...
Well, Lightning Storm, it was a...
Yeah, Lightning Storm, he had a 9/9. I mean, he needed to get that 9 off the board.
Yeah.
But he made a valiant effort at the comeback with the Druid. It didn't go all the way. What can you say?
I don't know, maybe just... Like, instead of throwing with the first Nourish...
Go for mana.
Try to be ahead on board somehow.
Yeah, I like the idea of going for mana with the first one instead of cards. His hand was kind of weak, but it's hard to say.
But also, when you go for turn 1 Living Roots, I think you are giving up some advantage in the matchup.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe he would have won if he went turn 1 3/4 instead.
I mean, it's just a tempo against a tempo.
Like, the thing
when,
is...
When you, if you are ahead, you are going to win. You have a good start. You can, like, with your hand, you can graph for 3 sometimes. So your three four is going to be alive most of the time. But with your 1/1s, you are not putting pressure. You are not doing anything. RDU played armor up, like, and everything went wrong from there.
Like, the thing is, with the way the matchup would have... turned out, RDU would have played his Fairy Dragon on 2. He could have coined out the 2/1 deal 2 damage. He would have killed it. He would have still played. It would have been the same scenario, just that he would have had a Living Roots in hand instead of a 2/1.
Because
he would have played.
So on turn 3, you play the 3/3 Ravaging Gold to kill my 2/1 and I have a 3/3.
Yeah.
But you can play Living Roots Hero Power on turn 3.
Yeah, and you have a 3/3.
You still have a 3/3.
Yeah, I don't know.
You are hitting 6 damage.
But
I mean,
he didn't do this, so...
Rip.
It's hard to say.
It's okay.
It's hard to say.
It's okay. Guys,
yep.
Thank you for watching. That's Powder, AK Wonder, SK Gaming, guys.
Stay tuned for Hot Form against...
PogChamp.
Jackie Chan.
Jackie Chan?
That's going to be a good game. Don't miss it.